Fine. Great. Now my nose is leaking. That's just great. It's just fucking great.
旅人。 有識の機能が失われた今、 正義を執行するために処刑人が必要だ。
That's me. I'm the new executor.
コンテーヌのすべての災いの元凶、予言を具現化した狂獣、その名も鈍性のクジラ。さあ、私についてきてくれ。処刑の時間だ。
Oh, piss off. Piss off. Don't do this to me after that shit. What am I doing, dude? My hands aren't on the keyboard. Great. The worst fucking boss in the game. Okay, so... Can I do anything to it right now? Yes. Yes, I can. Okay, he can do stuff to me, though. Alright, I have to learn a whole new boss, and I can only half see right now. Destroy it with... What? I don't have those attacks. Oh, shit. Okay, mate, look. My nose! Leave me alone, damn it! What the fuck? What? What? Boy, what a change of pace for the soundtrack. Oh god, I don't know what's going on. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I don't have P and O attacks. Now's not the time. I can't pay attention to three things at once. I don't have P or O attacks, man. Oh my god, I almost died. What do you mean cannot use? What can I not use? To interrupt his attacks, I see. Okay. Well, I don't see actually, but. I'm just gonna wail on everything. No pun intended. Oh. Hello? Right, the actual bitchy fight's not gonna happen until I actually have to fight this thing as a weekly. Did we win already? What the fuck? Who? Who the fuck are you? No! She just fucking tossed a child in the weird portal hole. With like one hand.
Thank you. ただこもって修行していただけだというのに、よもや弟子と師匠のペットが戦い始めてしまうとは予想はしていたが、少し早かったな。全くの誤算だ。帰ったら罰として素振りを300万回やらねば。
What?And why does it have to play this music again? This is the new... This music is the new... That one Sumeru song.
Ugh.
Yeah. Exactly. What?
Tartaria の師匠。スカークなんじゃないか？こないだタルタリアは口数が少ない人だったって言ってたような気がするけど、
弱者と話すことなどないだけだ。お前たちは世界の外の力に頼らず同性のクジラに勝った。故にお前たちには私と平等に話をする資格がある。
Wait, so child had a master named Skirk, apparently, who's like not of this world or has some insane abilitiesWhat did I miss? All I saw was some woman with some crazy wicked frickin' eyes and some like crazy sounding music. That might have been the whale boss though. Come out of nowhere, turn the whale into, I don't know, shards of stained glass, and then just picks up Child and tosses him like a fucking beanbag. Okay.
その考えには賛成だ。星の大会で鈍性のクジラのようなペットを飼うなど、どう考えても妙だしな。力の差が激しいし、触れ合いだってしにくい。それに食欲が旺盛すぎて、弟子の時間を犠牲にして見張る必要さえあるときた。ただまあ、干渉性は確かに悪くない。何にせよペットとして合格だとはとても言えんな。
スカークさん、多分だけど大事なところはそこじゃないと思うぞ。
大事なところ？
おお、
I don't fucking know anymore。
大事なのはそのペットが危うく国を滅ぼしかけたってところだ。お前の師匠、つまりタルタリアの師匠の師匠って一体誰なんだ？
知らなかったのか。すまない、彼を知っている前提で話をしてしまっていた。師匠はスルトロッチという。
Who? That's what I've been saying for like the past 10 minutes.
聞いたことのない名前だ。
師匠の知名度が足りなかったか。
The Fowl?It's a great name.
極悪鬼という称号を聞いたことはないか。
極悪鬼。
それも聞いたことがないのか。なら、
Visionary?
預言者ベゼルフェルニルは、黄金レインドットならどうだ。
レインドット、知ってるぞ。
マジ
のメンバーでアルベドのお母さんだよな。
アルベド's mom? What the fuck is going on?
今挙げた称号と名は、師匠から聞いたものでな。私も実際に知っているわけじゃない。だがこれでお前たちもより理解しやすくなったはずだ。私の師匠もレインドットと同じ類のものと言える。ある種の究極を求めるものだ。
ちょっと待てよ、さっき預言者とか言ってなかったか。おいらの聞き間違いか。
それより一刻も早くお前たちに伝えなくてはならないことがある。先ほど鈍性のクジラがお前たちと戦っていた時、全ての力を使い果たしたようでな。このように荒れ狂う水元素力はこの星の深海では消化が難しいのだ。理論上から言えばフォンテーヌの陸上はすでに大混乱に陥っているはずだ。つまりお前たちがずっと恐れていた予言は、
What? I thought we stopped that.
上演真っ只中ということだ。
なんだって？
Or at the very least, they won't be turned into oceanids? I don't... We knew this and accepted it. Okay, fine, but I thought something happened. I thought New Valette was like... Well, then again, I don't know what I was crying about as much as it was raining, so... Dude, don't start this shit again. What the fuck? Hope this is just metaphorical. Look, they didn't turn into oceanids. How is anyone alive? Watch out, you can end up killing people. It flies? I didn't know it flew! God damn it, fuck you, game. Thank God you don't have to hold your breath in this nation. I don't care what anyone says. That amount of water is gonna fucking destroy the city. There's nothing left. No more of it. Oh no, it did destroy the city. Look, the fucking buildings are crumbling. I told you. So it literally did happen. It's just that they didn't turn into oceanids again. I don't know why I feel like crying more. What the hell, dude? It's a happy ending. Okay, I'd say bittersweet, but...
ジュリエ氏は隠されし神秘の宝玉であった。人々は
一番初めの研究者を狂人と呼ぶが、二人目のことはどう呼ぶのだろうか。たとえ二人目が奇跡を成し遂げたとしても、そのもの自身とチームをまとめて指す言葉を見つけるのは難しい。おお、報道されてるのって本当にジュリエとナビアなのか？なんだか大物みたいに書かれてるぞ。
Son of a bitch, man. Jesus Christ, they started making me cry again. Okay, but isn't Nouvellet the Archon now? Like, officially? So then what does that make Farina? Just... Maybe that's why her attacks suck. She has the little water people do the work for her. Okay. Interesting. There's a lot to unpack here.
どう？どれも結構目を引くでしょ？スチームバード新聞の考えは至ってシンプルよ。災いが過ぎて間もない今、無料の上にいい知らせがびっしり書かれた特集で人々の心を癒すの。これらのビッグニュースの価値は常に続きがあること。続報では背後のストーリーに深く踏み込むの。エドウィンの助手ジュリエは本物の飛行船を作った。スピナディロースらのナビアは人々を率いて故郷を再建しようとしてる。
Dude, stop! 景
色の広い人たちですら目を引かれるものばかりでしょ。
オイラも気になるって一瞬思ったけど、よく考えたらどれもきっかけはオイラたちの身の回りで起こったことだったんだよな。だからこれ以上気になることなんてないぞ。
だからこそ一緒に取材に来てほしいの。わかる？君たちは最高のニュース提供者なんだから。それに君たちがいればあの公爵にだって絶対に会えるわ。
本当か？もうたくさん取材を断られてるんじゃなかったのかよ。
今度こそ大丈夫よ。行きましょう。まずはポア村長、それからメロピデ要塞に行くわ。現場に着いてからじゃないとわからないことだってあるのよ。
For a better tomorrow. Look, everyone's still dying. Tears among the stars? Okay, well, we're not done yet. We still got... Well, okay, if this is the end of the Archon quest, not overall, I mean... Usually, you always get to talk to the Archon at the end, right? And get to learn new stuff about the story that blows your freaking mind. And then you don't get to know anything else about it for another, like, year and a half. Like, when we learned that we're... forgot whatever the hell it was called. Goddammit, what we learned from Nahida, right? From the Doctor. Who we haven't seen since, by the way, which bodes well. I forgot what we are. We're the Traveler is special. Something from another place. Some sort of higher being, but I don't remember what it was called. Anyways, yeah, we learned about that, and then that was nothing. We didn't get to learn anything else about it. Unless, of course, there was a quest about it that I didn't play yet, but which is very possible. Well, we're not done yet, so there's no reason for me to sit around and start giving my opinions. Look, my fucking resin isn't even fully regenerated yet. That's how... little it's been. Okay. People rebuild their home. So, yeah, it's been rebuilt. I guess that's... I was like, there's no way there's not gonna be any damage, but all the trees were fucked, some of the houses were, like, broken into pieces and stuff. But they rebuilt. Everyone lived. I'm not gonna be that guy, but I can't believe that many people survived. I would have assumed that even if they're not gonna turn into Oceanids, drowning is still a very real thing. But I guess in the nation of Hydro, you can just breathe underwater or hold your breath. I thought that was only for certain people, not just anybody. But who knows? Whatever. Doesn't matter. I didn't know it was actually going to show it happen. So yeah, the prophecy remained true, but it wasn't the way that we perceived it to happen, so. But of course, the previous Archon, or the current Archon, well, it is the previous Archon now, just not the previous one, has to disappear from existence because, you know, it has to be depressing, which is fine with me. which I shouldn't cry for some bitch I don't know, god damn it. And then there's like this random woman that shows up out of this portal hole and just tosses child and lists off like 100 names I've never heard in my life. Who the hell are these people? What's going on? And my, I don't know, whatever. Son of a bitch. Alright, hold on just a moment. Oh wait, it also said I had mail. Oh, this is my check-in reward, I think. Yeah. My whopping 5 crystals. Okay, so where am I supposed to go here? Finale. We have to go to Poisson. We're probably just gonna go around and see how everyone's doing. This is like the, we already had the climax, and now this is the, whatever they call the after thing. Jeebus, creebus. Oh, I didn't read that water droplet that we got in our inventory here. Key items. There it is. Tears among the stars. A drop of water obtained from within the colossal beast who coveted the primordial sea of life. A philosopher in the faraway ancient world once... Hold on. Okay, microphone is posited. That where light there is life, there is death. Naturally, where there is death, there is life. If not, then the fleeting light cannot resist the eternal darkness, and all withers into nothingness at the end of time. The rules among the stars dictate that nature must be conserved. But the laws of the universe have never been conserved. In a sealed box, destruction always overpowers new life. Millennia upon millennia of prosperity are but an instant in a span of billions of years. The greatest of achievements, the proudest accomplishments, in time will all tarnish, decay, dissipate, and ultimately fade into oblivion. Thus there are things floating in among the stars, once adorned with countless prestigious titles from innumerable civilizations, shedding tears for their ordained demise. What the fuck? Their tears stream down out of desperation, out of hope, because all desperation and hope alike will be utterly extinguished along the innumerable stars. Their tears stream down out of sorrow, out of joy, because both will eventually scatter into the cold, dark, endless void. Every tiny yet beautiful silhouette and every moment worth remembering will fade with time, even stars. Well, this isn't fucking depressing at all. And then there are these so-called gods that are determined to save everything worth saving and devour everything that should be devoured until the end of time, until the sea of stars recess into nothing but dying embers, until a newborn world moves for the first time in the stomach of the whale. Why does there have to be a whale? There will be no more sins, no more sadness, and no more tears, because everything died with the ancient stars. Jeez, dude, I don't remember. Yeah, these other ones don't have fucking lore books. I guess that one kind of did, but good lord. All right, we got ourselves a new story collectible piece. We moved on in the world.
手持ちの情報を更新しなきゃと思って君たちの様子を見に来たってわけ。あれ？ファデュイの方もいるのね。ああ、紹介するね。こちらはグルント・スネージビッチ。召使いの代理としてスピナディロースらの業務を支援するための物資をいろいろと持ってきてくれたの。地元のみんなも精一杯頑張ってくれてるし、おかげさまで今のところは順調な方かな。
多くの人を失ったけど、それでも私たちは前に進み続けてる。それで十分だと思う。シャルロットさん、はじめまして。お名前は金金。昨年のフォンテーヌの野良猫に関する記事はとても興味深く拝読しましたよ。ただできれば大々的な報道はお控えいただけないでしょうか。これは別に善意によるものではなく、スピナディロースらと利益が一致しているから 行っているに過ぎないのです。よくわかりました。ご懸念は理解できますので、できるだけ軽く触れるにとどめますね。あるいは優しい隣人という呼び方はいかがでしょう。 悪くないですね。お心遣い感謝いたします。
ああ、おかえり。そっちはどうだった？
現在の準備は済んだ。王子の人たちは1時間後に到着することになっている。
あれ、クロリンデじゃないか。来る暇なんかあったのか？
実は最近例のフリーナ様との決闘騒ぎで超有名になっちゃったから、ポア村長まで逃げてきたのなんてね。嘘嘘、お手伝いに来てくれたのよ。
ポア村長を再建するためにやらねばならないことは山ほどある。スピナディロースらにはもっと決断できる人材が必要だし、お父上のカーレスさんとは少なからず関わりがあったから。
しばしお時間を。せっかくですのでちょっとお伺いできませんか？決闘前の心境や神を前にした際の姿勢について。
それはよしてくれ、シャルロット。もっといい取材テーマが見つけられるだろう。
相変わらずですね。ここは一つナビアの顔に免じていかがでしょう？
なんなら私の写真をたっぷり撮ってけば、彼女を説得する手間も省けるし、それか旅人の写真でもいいんじゃない？
もちろん彼女だって逃がしやしないわよ。では写真撮影に参加してくださる方は近寄ってください。はい、チーズ。
Oh god. You made You made shit leak out. Shit leak out. Ooh. I spit everywhere, goddammit.
Just wait. I'll take a few pictures. Hey, you guys. Okay, that's enough. I'll come back later. I'll keep it here today.
行動が素早いな。
スピードこそニュースの命だもの。フレッシュさが肝心よ。それに人の懐に入ってコネクションを作るのも私の得意分野だから、そのうちクロリンデさんをインタビューにお招きできるかも。
あんたって本当に打たれ強いね。頭が下がるよ。
おそらくメロピデ要塞が彼女の取材を受け入れたのもそういった方法で説得されたからだろう。
わあ、お耳が早いわね。私がシグウィンさんに尋ねた後、シグウィンさんからヌビレット様に伝わって、さらにヌビレット様がクロリンデさんに伝えた。そうでしょ？
綺麗に情報が連鎖していますね。
ヌビレット様はただ私に、メロピデ要塞はいつからメディアに対してそんなに友好的になったのかとお聞きになっただけだ。ヌビレット様の質問に対し、私は公爵が自ら出向くとは限らないから友好的になったとは言えない、そう申し上げたんだ。
その通り。彼らにインタビューできる時間は1分たりとも無駄にできないわ。善は急げって言うし、私たちはお先に失礼させてもらうわね。
じゃあ気をつけて。何か面白いニュースでもあったらまた帰ってきて聞かせてよね。お礼に美味しいアフタヌーンティーでもてなすから。
メロピデ要塞の状況が気になるのか？
まあね。リオセスリったら前にわざわざ水の下まで行ってパパの事件について聞いたのに、堂々巡りで結局何も教えてくれなかった。
Excuse me?
代わりにお茶をごちそうになったんだったか。
ティーポット2つ分もいただいちゃった。お茶の味は確かに悪くなかったけどね。
私もあそこのお茶は悪くないと思ってる。
あ、そういえば今日一緒にお茶でもどう？どうせ暇でしょ。
バタービスケットも欲しい。
注文までしてくれちゃって。たく、まあいいでしょ。
うん。
I'm surprised that
スネージビッチさんはどんな味のビスケットがお好きなの？
私ですか？どんな味でも。もしチョコレート味があればなお嬉しいですが。
了解、任せて。
スネージビッチさん、後ほど今日新しく届けていただいた物資の確認作業を手伝おう。それで今日中に準備が終わるはずだ。
それはありがたい。助かります。
あれ？リップ変えた？
うん。この間、シグウィンさんにプレゼントしてもらったんだ。試してみるか？この色なら、あなたにも似合いそうだ。
I'm surprised that, with the fact that the story's over, well, unless there's, you know, like an act six, an intermission act or anything like that, not counting that, but that the core of the Fontaine story is over with, I'm surprised that these characters haven't been released yet, because they're 100% playable characters. She's going to be a 5-star, this is probably, Chlorine is probably going to be a 4-star, and there's also that little nurse thing, girl, cute character, that's clearly also going to be playable. But isn't released, and it just feels weird that they would prioritize. In my opinion, okay, nothing against Charlotte, but it just feels weird that they would prioritize Charlotte over like Chlorine, for example, as a 4-star. I would say Navia, but since she's a 5-star, I guess they have to work in the other 5-stars first. But I don't know. That's just me. Who knows? I'm sure they'll get their time to shine at some point. Hopefully not anytime soon, because I don't have Primigems to spare. Oh, here we are, we're back. There's that classic music from the other day. Actually, yesterday. Actually, today. It's still the same day. What the fuck? I feel like I've been through the ringer in the past half hour here. There's ever a guy I'd let screw me. I didn't say that. You didn't hear that.
どういたしまして。ただし、インタビューの主な対象は俺じゃない。交わした約束を覚えているかい？
あ、それはもちろんです。
さあ、こちらへ。
写真撮影は終わりましたから、そんなに緊張しなくていいですよ。
シャルロットさん、今の写真が本当にスチームバード新聞の一面に載るのですか？
あるいは。
Wait, they didn't get the... Hold on, but I didn't see it.
What?
My brain is elsewhere right now, hold on.
違います。僕はただ、インタビューなんて初めてですから、わざわざ僕にインタビューしに来てくれた、スチームバード新聞にありがたい気持ちで。
そうは見えないかもしれませんが、私はエドウィンさんにも一度お会いしたことがあるんですよ。でもここだけの話、あなたとおしゃべりする方が私は好きです。あなたは彼よりもさらに素晴らしいテンポの才をお持ちでいらっしゃると思います。奇跡を運ぶ船舶、世の人を救う運ぶね。
The Ark, that's what I said.
伝説に出てくる使者のように神話を再現なさったんですから。
And I didn't know it even flew.
その空飛ぶ船は今どこにあるんでしょうか？
シャルロットのやつ、またスクープを狙ってるな。
大変申し訳ないが、あの船は今工場の奥にあるんだ。撮影のご案内はちょっと難しそうだな。
そうなのですか？ではその穴埋めといってはなんですが、あなたにインタビューしても？
Well, it's just her job.
答えはあんたもよくご存知だろう。俺なんかより看護師長をインタビューするか、あるいはこちらの天才研究員コンビの写真をもっと撮った方がいい。
どうしてコンビの写真って強調
なってるんですか？Nice. I picked up on that too.
一人ずつ2回撮らせていただくということで。
僕の髪がおかしくないか、ちょっと見てくれないか？
メロピデ要塞にもこんなに賑やかな日があるなんてな。
って、待てよ。よく考えてみたら、前にも賑やかな時があったよな。
あらら、みんな揃って。ね、打 ちが作った新しい飲み物を飲んでみない？
お、看護師。
A new drink？
あのシャルロットさん、どうぞメロピデ要塞の看護師長の素敵な写真も撮って差し上げてください。
もちろん。シグミさん、私についてきていただけますか？人が少なくて明るい場所がいいので。
ん？わかった。写真を撮るときは笑った方がいいの？
それでここ最近メロピデ要塞はどうだったんだよ。
見ての通り相変わらずさ。コンテナで起きた変動はここにまでは大した影響は与えなかった。
あの空飛ぶ船以外はですけどね。あれは目立ちすぎるのでみんなが気になってるみたいで。
インタビューを受け入れたのもそのためさ。舞台裏の英雄にこそ世論のスポットライトは当てられるべきだ。そう思わないかい、ジュリエ、ルールビ
ー。身に余るお言葉です。公爵も適度に表に出られた方がいいと思いますが、あなたはそれを嫌がりますから。
スポットライトはやっぱりあんたらとこの二人の功労者に譲るよ。なるほど。あの日それだけのことが起きていたのか。あの執行官についてだが。
Well, I don't know where the hell he's at now. He got He just got tossed.
奴の帰りを待っている。
本当に一途だな。
彼らにはいい知らせと悪い知らせがあると伝えよう。いい知らせは彼らの兄貴がさほど多くの危険には遭遇していなかったこと。
Like, the country just, like, almost got destroyed. Can let him, let him off the hook. Technically, it did get destroyed. It just was rebuilt.
メロピデ要塞はこれからも同じように稼働し続けるだろうし、ここにいる俺の責任も変わりはしないさ。フリーナ様が去ったことが何を意味するのか、果たしてフォンテーヌの制度はこれから変わるのか。
So people know that she's not the Archon now?
水の上の人たちに悩んでもらおう。
皆さん、
Hence the departure comment. Well, I haven't had a moment to talk yet, but.
じゃあ、今日のインタビューはこれでお開きにしよう。
ご協力、どうもありがとうございました。旅人、帰りましょう。またお邪魔させてもらいますね。
また？
ええ。もしかしたら水中工場の記事を書くことになるかもしれませんので、その時はまたよろしくお願いします。よし、最後の目的地は不当よ。
I was gonna say, I don't remember ever seeing the Hydrognosis. So, and obviously Farina didn't have it because she wasn't the Archon. But where is it? Does New Valette now have it? Because I didn't see the Focalors, or whatever the hell her name is. I didn't see her pass that to New Valette when she gave him the power, or reinstated his power. So I don't know. Because usually at the end of every questline in the Archon story, at the end of every chapter, the Fatui walk right off with their gnosis that they won, you know, or was given to them, and they win the day. But I haven't seen that happen yet, unless we go to talk to New Valette and he's like, yes, I gave it to the knave, because whatever, some reason.
シャルロットさんが撮った公爵の写真が見たいんだけど。
そんな必要あるかい？俺たちの業務に写真が必要な場面なんかほとんどないだろう。
必要ないからこそ記念としての価値があるのよ。でもその表情から見るにまんざらでもなさそうね。
俺は写真に写らなくてよかったって表情かもな。インタビューも順調だった。
ルールビーさんとジリエさんが人々の興味津々な視線を遮る盾になってくれてよかったのよ。
祝福しよう、若者二人の明るい前途をな。
Oh, is that them over there?
Interview の時のメモだ。空飛ぶ船が今後いろんな場面で使われるかもしれないってことも書かれてるよ。それについてどう考えてるかって記者の人に聞かれたけど、どうって聞かれてもそんなの知るわけないだろ。飛行船はただの飛行船さ。それを使って朗報を広めるだの、結婚式に使うだの、知ったこっちゃない。
結婚？
なんでそんな顔でこっちを見るんだ。
空飛ぶ船を結婚式に使えるんですか。
僕じゃなくてあの記者さんが言ったんだよ。それと僕たちに何の関係があるんだ。
確かに私たちに何の関係があるんでしょう。
They're totally gonna bone, or already have, I don't know. Okay, so next, where are we going? We're going back to the harbor. Who's at the harbor? Okay, it's all the way down at the bottom. I remember when we came here for the first time. Those were the days. Way back in the day. Who's down here? Oh, it's Lynette and... Oh, it's the three siblings, I guess.
とは手を組んだ時以来連絡を取り続けてるらしいわ。ね、最近あの子たちは不当なあたりで不思議なポケットを配ってるって。
旅人パイモン、それにシャルロットさん。
あお。
マジックポケットはいかが。
それって何かすごいものなの。
Stick your penis. Never mind.
海水の水位は戻ったけど。まだ至るところの水たまりに物が浮かんでる。このポケットを使えば運ぶことができるし、
okay.
お友達に運んでもらうこともできるから。
友達に運んでもらうって一体。
Why is she looking at us?
友達がいれば力を貸してもらえる。そうでしょ、フレミネ。
友達を作るのを手伝ってくれるってこういうことだったのか。
なかなかいいアイディアね。もしよかったら連絡先を教えてもらえる。
What?
わかった。
Oh! Contact, like address. I thought she meant like the eyeball contact. I was so confused.
フレミネに人と交流してもらうために頑張ってるんだな。
フレミネの方からもっと友達を作って人と交流したいって言い出したのよ。それにマジックショーのアシスタントもやってみたいって。
There's a lot of things that would suit the three of you.
ああ、まずはショーのアシスタントとしてペールスにも出てもらって、その後フレミニにも加わってもらおうと思ってるんだ。今後水中脱出は大方フレミニに任せられそうかな。
潜水士の水中脱出を見たいと思う人はいるかしら。
ま、きっとうまくいくさ。何事もまずは初めの一歩から。そのうちフレミネも僕たちのマジックショーの一員になるだろう。
リネット、ちょっといい。シャルロットさんが僕たちの写真を撮ってくれるって。
今行く。
シャルロットさんは本当によく気がつく人だね。僕が話したいことがあるのを読んで場を用意してくれるなんて。それで、旅人、最近どうだい？
It's been pretty fucking stupid. That's what it's been.
お父様から聞いたけど、ここ最近君たちには大いに世話になったそうだね。 君たちがフォンテーヌのために力を貸してくれたことに感謝してたよ。
大したことじゃないぜ。フォンテーヌにはオイラたちの知り合いもいっぱいいるしな。そういえば召使いは今どうしてるんだ。
ああ、まだ知らなかったんだね。実はそう、フリーナ様が去った後、お父様とヌビレット様との間で話し合いが行われてね。
Oh for fuck's sake.
結局フォンテーヌの神の心は
What did I fucking say? I just They're Come on.
ああ、僕も最初はすごく驚いたけど、よく考えてみ
て。 I don't have a problem with that. I just have a problem with the reasoning.
例えば、
Even Nahida had a better reason for giving the Gnosis over. I was just joking earlier, basically, when I said that.
それだけじゃなくて、以前からお父様はフォンテーヌの機関やポア村長のことをいろいろと手伝ってたからね。
それにしたっていくらなんでも、だって神の心なんだぞ。
I don't necessarily think it's irresponsible. I just think the.
それもそうかもね。
I don't know if I should be really critical right now or not.
ヌビレット様はこの件に対して明らかな態度の変化があったって噂だよ。
I just think it's really lazy writing. That's what I think. You know, once upon a time, the Harbingers were actually stealing them and earning them through stealing them successfully, not just getting them fucking handed to them over and over again. Oh, he survived? Okay. He wasn't.
前回の災いが起こった時、彼は生死の境をさまよってたからね。
Here, I was assuming he got tossed into the ether.
そうそう。今までファルイとの間じゃ、いざこざがたくさんあったけど、まさか今回は、ファデュイと味方になるなんてな。
立場が変わっただけのこと、それほど驚くことがあるかな。
Who? Is that just the knave? Yeah, thought so.
お父様、子供たちの様子を見に不当に来たのに、旅人にも会えるとは。フォンテーヌでの私の成果についてはあまり気にしないでくれたまえ。それは必然の結果とも言えるのだから。
そのお前は神の心をスネジナヤに持ち帰るのか。
スネジナヤ、
我々執行官の責務だ。立場にこだわる必要などない。ファデュイが目指すゴールはある場所や個人ではなく、この世そのもの。これほど壮大なゴールを掲げる我々としては、複数の顔を持たないことの方が難しいだろう。そしてまさにこの私も様々な顔を見せ続けてきた。それは未来の多種多様な可能性によって決まる。私は誰かに長いスパンでの約束を言い渡されたとしても信頼しないし、自らもそんな約束はしない。一時にとどまるのみの真摯さは本当の真摯さとは言えないからね。また次に手を取り合える日を楽しみにしていよう。善行は一人では成し遂げられないからね。それに君たちは実に優秀な協力者だった。神の目了解した。講師のため大切に預かってくれていたんだね。ありがとう。
こっちはおい、まさか。
こんにちは、記者のお嬢さん。
こんにちは。私の記憶が間違ってなければ、あなたのお写真を撮らせていただくためには確か外務省に届ける必要がありますよね。
おっしゃる通り、残念ながら君の取材には応じることができない。代わりと言ってはなんだが、この子たちの魔術師としての そして未来の神聖魔術師としての一面をたっぷり書いていただければ嬉しい限りだ。
はい、お任せください。
実に気持ちいい海風だ。天気がいいうちに散歩の続きでもするとしよう。では失礼する。
お父様、それではまた。
あの方すごい威圧感だったね。シャッターを押す勇気すら出なかった。まあ幸い取材はほぼ終わったし、これだけの材料があれば記事を書くには十分かな。本当にありがとね。
そう固くならないで。そうだ、お別れの前にマジックポケットをもらってくれるかな。旅人とパイモンも一つずつどうぞ。
物を運ぶためのポケットだっけか。
そうだよ、確か君たちに初めて会った時も僕たちはマジックポケットを配ってたね。そして今偶然にも同じことをやってる。いろんなことが起きたけど、ポケットはあの時と全く変わっていない。これこそが人生ってやつなのかな。人生の道で遭遇する全ての出会いは縁に導かれた結果なんだね。よし、また他のエリアでもポケットを配らないとだから、お先に失礼するね。旅人、パイモン、いい一日を。
シャルロットも見送り終わったし、ルビレットの様子を見に行こうぜ。あいつ、オイラたちと話をする暇がないくらい忙しかったりしないといいんだけど。
To be completely fair about the Gnosis issue that I have, I don't remember what happened with the Geonosis. I don't remember how the Fatui or Fatus obtained that, but I'm assuming it had something to do with child. But the only one I do remember vividly as being the only person worth any salt was Signora, the one who successfully stole the Gnosis from Venti. Or maybe Venti meant for that to happen. I don't know. I don't give a shit. Either way, she took it with her hands. She took it. But then fucking you go to Inazuma, it gets handed over for your life. Okay, fine. The story reason is it's to protect you. Whatever. It gets handed over. Then you go to Sumeru. It gets handed over for knowledge. Okay, at least you get something out of it. You come to Fontaine. It gets handed over because of a good gesture or something. Maybe he'll explain to us. But three times in a row, possibly four, because I don't remember what happened with the Geo one, but at least three times in a row, it's just been handed over to them. Not earned in battle or some, you know, stolen. Or some shit. But I guess what they really want now is for us to start realizing that the Fatui aren't just inherently evil, so they want to start easing you into the idea that maybe they have intentions that are beyond your recognition. Wait, where am I going? What? Oh, he's not in this place. He's around back. So they don't want the Fatui taking it by force over and over, because then you might keep wanting to fight them. I don't know, whatever. That was a bit disappointing. I made that a joke earlier when I said, oh, the new Villette will say, I just gave it to him. And then, fucking, that's exactly what happened. And I guess we'll find out. Maybe he'll say something about it. He'll be like, I've seen the future, and it's really important for them to have it. Or some crap. I like that.
やっぱり。ああ。君たちはリネ君に会ってきたのか。そういえば前に彼がここを通りかかって挨拶してくれた。ちょうどよかった。君たちに説明が間に合わなかった部分についてきちんと答えると約束していただろう。いいタイミングを探っていたところだ。
覚えてくれてたのか。事後処理で忙しいはずなのに。オイラたちにまで気を回してくれてたなんて。じゃあ早速だけど、フォンテーヌが一体どうやって救われたのか教えてくれよ。オイラにとっちゃ未だに謎だらけだぞ。
多くの物事は語ろうとするとかえって戸惑いを感じてしまうものだな。
Okay, so now we get to know the whole story. Deceive the heavenly principles and use Farina's endless performance to save Fontaine. Oh god, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Now I gotta pee, dude.
フォカルルスが水陣の科目らを壊したことで力を返してもらったお前が完全な状態の水元素の流王になった。でもまだ謎が残ってるぞ。お前は具体的にどうやってフォンテーヌの人が解けるのを防いだんだ。私にとって古竜の体験とは水元素を掌握する絶対的な力のことを意味している。フォンテーヌの人類は最初、ヘゲリアが大海の力を利用して作った不完全な人類であり、つまりは擬態にも似たような形態だった。しかしフォンテーヌ人の体内に大海のエネルギーが存在する限り、私は古竜の権能を駆使し、この星で最初の命が育まれた時の過程を真似て彼らに真の血液を与えることができる。
Won't that just like piss off Celestia again though?
私が判決を下したその瞬間、フォンテーヌ人は真の人類となり、二度と原始大海の水に溶けることはなくなったのだ。
フォカルルスはそこまで計算してたのかよ。それこそが予言が実現したと見せかけると同時に、全ての人を救える鍵だったんだろうな。
So when I pulled for Nouvellet, I actually was pulling for the Archon.Technically, long before the actual, what I thought was the Archon was available. That's weird. This is weird.
だな。ある意味、フォカルルスはこの方法で純粋精霊を人類に変えてあげたいっていう初代水神の願いも叶えてやったってことか。
その表情から察するに、どうやら他にも聞きたいことがあるようだ。
Yes.
遠慮なく聞いてくれたまえ。
Here it is.
知っていることならばすべて答えよう。
Here we go. This is it. This is the end of the Archon chapter. Bullshit that we get to do every time. And is there anything about? There's nothing about my brother. We haven't seen him in 10 years. Because it's always 10 years. About the initial verdict that was passed on Child. Yeah, I don't have an answer for that.
タルタリア殿の一件について多方面から調べていたのだが、その結果ある事実に行き当たった。彼は幼い頃、
What?
未知なる深淵に落ちたことがあり、その際偶然にも鈍性のクジラを呼び覚ましてしまったのだ。しかしだからといってタルタリア殿を災難の根源だと断定するのは理にかなっていないし、情に欠けた判断だ。せいぜい責任の一端はあるという程度だろう。あの審判で有識が下した判決についてだが、一部の責任に基づく判決だったのか、あるいは彼が論性のクジラと牽制し合えると予測したホカロルスは彼にフォンテーヌの身代わりとなって時間を稼いでもらう算段だったのか知る由もない。
なんだかんだ言ってホカロルスはフォンテーヌ人のことを思ってたんだな。最終的にフォンテーヌ人が本当の人類になれたのもあいつのおかげだし。あ、ふと思ったんだけど、フォンテーヌ人が本当の人類になる前って、あいつらから生まれた子供も純粋精霊が変わったやつだったのか？
命はもとより水のように絶えず循環するもの。フォンテーヌ人がよくここルキナの泉を訪れ子宝祈願をすることは覚えているか？
覚えてるぜ。ここはフォンテーヌのすべての水が交わる場所だってリネットが言ってたぞ。
その子宝祈願が実は単なる風習ではなくある種の儀式であったことは当の夫婦たちも知らなかった。祝福を受けた泉の中の純粋精霊たちが数ヶ月後本当に新たなフォンテーヌ人として生まれてくることをね。
もう大体分かった気がするぞ。今となってはもういらなくなったけど、あれは風習として受け継がれてきた儀式だったってことだな。
遠慮なく聞いてくれたまえ。私の知っていることならば全て答えよう。
Fontaine's future.
So, Ryosesuri kara Furina ga dokka ichchatta tte kiita kedo, douyu koto nan da?
Furina nitsuite wa minshuu ni shirarete iru no wa kanojo no shokei ga jissai ni wa shikkou sarenakatta koto no mi. Suijin no kurai o orita kanojo wa sono katagaki ni kakawaru jimuteki na shigoto o watashi ni hikitsugi kagekijou o hanareta. Watashi wa Hokarorusu no saigo no kotoba o chūjitsu katsu kanzen ni kanojo ni tsutaeta. それを聞いたフリーナは悲しい表情もほっとした表情も見せなかった。彼女はただ疲れたから休むとだけ口にした。
I'm sure we'll get to learn more in her story quest.
引っ越しをする一般人のように歌劇場を去ったのだ。
フリーナ、それであいつが住める場所はあるのか？
そこは安心していい。彼女の衣食住についてはこちらでしっかり手配する予定だ。正直なところ、私は心の片隅では彼女のために喜んでいる。彼女の中に積み重なってきた精神的な傷が癒えるまでには時間がかかるだろうがね。だが彼女はもう水神ホカロルスを演じる必要がなくなった。これからは全ての荷を下ろし普通の暮らしをしていけるだろう。
お前は水流の全ての力を手に入れたわけだろ。これからどうするつもりなんだよ。
ホカロルスの聖家と共に輸出最低カーディナルも止まった。これは審判に直接的な影響を与えることだ。慎重に考えた結果、審判におけるその役割は私が代わりに担うことにした。これからは私自ら審判を下す。
やっぱりお前は完全に最高審判官の立場から物事を考えてるんだな。
元素流として私にはまだ成し遂げられていないことが数多くある。しかしこの力、そしてこの責任はある意味では与えられたものだ。だから他の責任を果たす以前に、私はまず最高審判官として引き続きフォンテーヌに貢献していかなければならない。それらの責任は今後私の生活の中で共存していくだろう。それから水神が去ったことによって生じるもう一つの問題は、歌劇場から立証混合エネルギーが発生しなくなってしまったことだ。
そっか、確かそのエネルギーって水神に対する人々の信仰心から作られるんだったよな。でも町にある機械はみんなちゃんと動いてるぞ。一体どこからエネルギーをもらってるんだ？
今の私はプネウムシアを完全にコントロールできるようになった。このエネルギーは代替エネルギーとして何ら遜色がない。これは私がしばらくフォンテーヌを離れられない理由でもある。
おお、古竜の力ってめちゃくちゃ便利だな。
遠慮なく聞いてくれたまえ。私の知っていることならば全て答えよう。
Okay, explain to me the Gnosis business.
あ、そうだ。神の心を外交的な贈与として召使いにやったって聞いたぞ。
あの二人の執行官は今回の災難で確かに大いに貢献してくれた。彼ら自身がそうしたかったからという個人的な部分は置いておくとして、パデュイがフォンテーヌにいる目的は表向きにはただ一つ、神の心のためだ。輸出最低カーディナルが止まり、水神のカムクラさえなくなった今、私も神の心の力を必要としなくなった。フォンテーヌにとって神の心は完全に意味を失ったものだ。もしファデュイの目的がそう単純なものでないなら、これを機に彼らの要求に応えてしまえば諸々の無駄な手間が省けるだろう。
なんだか複雑な考え方だな。There's some serious.
単に召使いへのお礼と。
There's some serious conflicting logic in what he just said.
遠慮なく聞いてくれたまえ。
Like, I've already stated my belief and possible even interest. Well, okay, that's not even possible. My high interest and belief that the Fatui, there's more to them than.Just being evil, you know, that their intentions are most likely good, even if their actions aren't such. But to the rest of the world, including us, regardless of my input, the Traveler and everyone else just fucking hates these guys and all their guts. So I don't give a shit if the Gnosis doesn't have a use in Fontaine anymore and you wish to avoid conflict. You know that they're after the Gnosis's is, right? You should at least assume that, oh, well, these guys, you know, they're kind of nasty sometimes. Maybe they're building a fucking nuclear weapon that can detonate the entire planet with the press of a button. You know, some shit like that. Why would you just hand it over just because it has no use to Fontaine anymore? And because you want to avoid conflict. You might literally be creating conflict by giving it to them down the road. I don't know, whatever. Even if I don't personally believe that, I'm just trying to see this from the perspective of every other character that exists in this world that hates the guts of any Fatus. Okay, well, anyways, the only other question we have is about our next stop on our journey, which, if I'm not mistaken, should be the nation of Natlan, the nation of fire or pyro, whatever, which I'm also extremely excited to see.君たちは猛獣、ナトラン。ガイドも才能は全くないが、私の知っている範囲の異ならば。Tell me, tell me, tell me, tell me. Tell me this volcano there. 私の知る限り、ナタは竜の国だ。え?竜の国?お前みたいな竜のことか?いや。私が、ナタで歓迎されるようなことはないと思うがね。私のような人々は違って、おそらくナタの竜は、 長い変遷と進化を経て、今やその大勢が人類と共存している。What?そこは戦争の終わりなき戦火が延々と広がっている。Oh!それから、君たちにとって役に立ちそうな情報がある。召使徒の談判で、思いもよらず知ったことだが、隊長という名のファトゥスが、すでにその終わりなき戦争に加わっていることだ。The captain.
隊長、なんだか手強そうな響きだぜ。本当にどこに行ってもあいつらファトゥスの活躍が見られるんだな。万全の準備をした上でナタに行くことをお勧めする。それまでは心ゆくまでフォンテーヌに滞在してくれていい。遠慮なく聞いてくれたまえ。
Okay, I heard all I needed to hear. Dragons coexisting with humanity, the land of the nation of war, and war is always raging. Hell yes, count me in. I gotta see this. Can't wait for it to be a massive disappointment. But no, I have expectations, and so far almost all of my expectations in this game have always lived up to that, if not blown it out of the water, so...
もう一つ聞きたいことがあるんだ。この前リネはお前が神の心を渡すことについて明らかな態度の変化があったって言ってたんだけど。お前が知らない理由でもあるんじゃないかって、俺たちは推測してたんだぞ。ふむ。ハウスオブハースがファディの情報機関を務めているのもうなずける。実に鋭い観察だ。その質問については、 ちょうど君たちに共有しておきたいことがある。え?まだあるのか?あの日、君たちをゲンシ大会から陸地へ送り返した後、私はスタッフと名乗るあの人物とこのような会話をした。Okay,
maybe there'll be more context for him giving the Gnosis away so that I can stop bitching about it.
さて。よし。毒性のクジラはもういない。邪魔はなくなったな。お前の力に含まれた成分もやっと嗅ぎ分けられるようになったぞ。この星の最初の古竜の剣能。そこに 神の呪いにも似たものが加わっている。とても新鮮だ。ふむ。一体何だったか。記憶にはあるはずなんだが。何を言っているか全く理解できないのだが。ああ、思い出した。なんだ。答えは簡単なことやもしれん。さてはお前、
第三降臨者の遺骨を持っているな。The remains?
遺骨? そんなもの聞いたこともないが。
ふむ。お前たちのよく使う言葉で言うなら、確か神の心と言ったか。
Wait, a gnosis's remains? What?
ホカロルスの神格が消え去った後、神の心は私に預けられた。しかし、
I guess that's what that means.
君が今言ったことについ
ては、I thought it was...
間違いなく
like someone's ashes.
私は幼い頃から師匠について武術を学び、地上に戻ったことがなくてな。触れる情報はほとんどが極悪鬼によるものだった。だからかもしれん。元より人類の上位にある存在だから、彼の常識も当然人とは異なる。そのせいか、私たちと人類との交流にはいつも多くのズレが生じるんだ。そのことはともかく、不吉なものは災いが起こる前に消した方がいい。人が生きることは本来であれば祝福されるべきことだ。しかし死んでしまえば、本人とこの世の間にあった無数の関わりはやがて呪いとなり果てる。
何が言いたい？
そう身構えないでくれ。ただ個人的な感想を言ったまでだ。これは私が地上に戻りたくなかった理由でもあるがな。
君の言う第三降臨者とは一体誰のことだ？まだそれはいつ死んだのだ？
師匠は私に何も教えてくれなかった。おそらく私にとって大して重要なことではなかったからだろう。だが興味があるというなら、今度師匠に聞いてこよう。
今度また会えるのか？
うむ。ああ、そういえば私には弟子が一人いてな。何かあればあいつに伝えさせよう。
I didn't learn anything except that these are remains of a descender.
役に立つかどうかは分からぬが、まずは君たちに伝えておきたいと思ったのだ。
第三降臨者の
Third descender.
遺骨？神の心がそうなのか？シェスの駒みたいな形。
Yeah, I didn't know they were remains, but
あれは遺骨だったってことか？
So the remains of
話が誤解や変わった比喩でもない限りは。
で、不吉で手放した方がいいってあいつに言われたから、お前はパデュイにやったのかよ。
もしスカーク殿の話が本当ならば、それがフォンテーヌにある限り、危険の種となりうるだろう。
But she mentioned one of them. So you're telling me that descenders are.Gnosis's, the remains, and they've what, just been passed down through time via archons? I don't fucking know. Oh, okay, this is what we were, a descender. That's what we learned at the end of the Sumeru storyline. We are the fourth descender, I guess. This information means two things. One, that I am not a deceased descender, but I might become a Gnosis at some point. Okay, I don't know. I am the fourth descender.One, that the Gnosis are related to descenders, okay? And two, that the one who came before me has already died. Who came before you? The third descender? I guess that would make sense. You had one, two, three, and now I'm the fourth, so the previous ones would have had to have died. And if the third descender is a Gnosis already, then that's confirmation of their remains, so they're dead.I don't know, dude. I don't know what the hell's going on here. This is too much for my little brain. Thank God I don't have to write down notes and try to make a thoughts and opinions video on this. Jesus Christ.
降臨者という概念を認識しているだろうとは思っていたが、君自身が降臨者であるとは予想だにしなかった。となると、元素に対する極めて高い適応力を持ち、ひいては元素力を増幅することさえできる神の心の力は、第三降臨者に由来するわけか。君も似たような性質を持っているのか。
そうだな。神の目を持ってないのに、 元素力を操れる能力とかか？これも特別な適応力って言えるかな？いやいや、とりあえずは余計なことを考えないでおこうぜ。
So the third descender created the Gnosis's?
What?
Here, I was thinking that each descender was a Gnosis, but no, I guess it's just the third descender's remains are the Gnosis's. Fuck that word, dude. I won't die so easily.
どういうことなのか、あいつから子孫にちゃんと聞いてもらわないとな。同感だ。情報が揃っていない状況で根拠のない推測をするのはあまり賢明なやり方ではない。法廷と同じでね。これで予言にあったフォンテーヌの危機もやっと一段落ってとこだな。そうだな。ホカロルスの努力も全てはこの時のためだった。
だけど神として自分を犠牲にして人間としては500年も辛い思いをしながら生きてきて、それって本当にあいつが望んだことだったのかな。神の願いというのはそもそもの不思議な謎なのかもしれない。私には無理だ。ただ時々こんな想像をしてみることがある。 もし願いが空の雲だとすれば、それはいつの日か雨となって大地に降り注ぐのだろう。命は水のように絶えず循環し、雨は最終的なことを与える。水は傾くことがあるが、雨はどこまでも平等に降るのだ。雨、雨。君や私、あの人が浴びる雨に果たして何の違いがあろうか。
Chapter 4, Act 5, Masquerade of the Guilty. Damn. Fuck this game. Yep. Prepare before going to Natlan. Well, I have to wait before I can go there. We did it. We finished the Fontaine Archon storyline for the time being until we see what comes next for quests in this game. Well, that was screwy, that whole thing. I mean, I think overall, the climax was definitely not expected. There was some twists in there that I didn't see coming. Like, I definitely knew there was more, like I said earlier, there was more than meets the eye to Farina, but I didn't realize she just wasn't the Archon, but kind of is a reflection of the Archon anyways. That I didn't see coming. I also didn't know Nouvellet was a dragon. I didn't know he was going to become the new Archon. I didn't know... There's all these things that were unexpected in the end, and I also didn't expect it to really be as sad as it was. I don't want to say it was crushingly depressing. I still think that maybe the disappearance of the previous Archon in the Sumeru storyline is a bit more depressing because her legacy no longer exists, except with us. And that's it. We're the only ones that get to know. So she never existed. She's nothing more than void, which is very depressing. While this one, I wasn't expecting the Archon to die again, basically, or disappear, as it were. But at least her legacy will live on in the end. And as for Farina, we don't get a conclusion to her story at all, which I'm guessing is what her actual story quest is for. But considering she only has one part right now, and it seems like most of the Archons seem to get two story quests. They all have two story quests except Venti and Farina, but she's new, so I won't count that. I don't know if I'm going to rush right into her story quest. I was actually going to. What I was originally planning to do was I was going to do the Archon quest, which we've now finished, and then I was going to do Farina's story quest. But since she only has one part right now, I'm probably going to wait, maybe, and we'll check it out at another time. But we'll see. I don't know. Maybe I'll change my mind on that regardless. Overall, though, not to really comment on Fontaine as an exploration thing, but as far as story-wise, I really liked Fontaine. I mean, the first two acts of Fontaine were really exciting because of all, like, the mystery aspect and the whole courtroom stuff. That was really fun to work through. And then, you know, going into Act 3 and Act 4, where you spend a majority of your time in a prison, which was also really interesting. I liked the music there. I liked uncovering more mysteries and stuff, trying to figure things out. Even if the payoff wasn't what I would have really liked to see for, like, the mystery of what was going on down there, I would have liked, of course, you know, it's no big surprise. Here's the Tigerfrost cliche of the century, which is I would have liked it to be darker, but I still enjoyed all of that. And then, of course, Act 4 started focusing on some of the catastrophe stuff, and then Act 5 was fucking insane, as it should be, since it's the climax to the entire chapter of the storyline. So I expect it to be big. Now, did I like it more than the previous Archon chapters? I mean, the battle against the whale is probably not as big of a spectacle as, like, the fight with the giant sea creature or whatever in Leeway during that Archon story. But visually it was cool, I guess. But as far as previously, I think my favorite story was Sumeru, just because of how saddening it was. Everything in Sumeru seems to be depressing as shit. And I it's hard for me to determine if I like Fontaine's story more, or kind of the same, or a little bit less. I'd say that overall, of all of the chapters, this is probably, like, in the top three. I would probably even put Fontaine above Inazuma. So I'd probably say that Fontaine's in at least second place. It's either in first place, with Sumeru in second, and then Inazuma in third place. Otherwise, I think it's still Sumeru in first place, and then Fontaine in second place, with Inazuma in third. That's where I think I stand on it for right now, but we'll see. You never know. Some awesome cutscenes, of course, lots of really cool cutscenes that happened there. And of course, it made me emotional. I did actually cry more than I did when I was doing the Sumeru quest. And I did my best to not make too much noise until after the cutscene. I was doing that thing I do when I watch anime, because I often record my reactions to anime, when I start to cry, to the point where I'm going to make noise, I will just sit there and silently push all of those tears out of my face. And then, you know, it's getting all nasty and gross, but I try not to start breathing until after the cutscene. Otherwise, I'm going to start audibly crying, and I didn't want to make the cutscene awkward. So I just waited as long as I could. But there was definitely more tears here than there was during the Sumeru storyline, which is surprising to me because I didn't know folklores really, you know, I didn't know for the whole, I started to get pretty emotional. I got kind of teary eyed a bunch as we got closer and closer to the climax because of the more we learned about Farina, how she is this, she's not even a puppet. She did this, and she's been doing this for centuries, and all of it has been a facade, right? But that was the point the whole time. And all those answers coming out as to why she has no power, oh, it's because she's not actually the Archon. She's just essentially acting as one and her role in this play is going to help save everyone. That's why she can't tell anybody anything, because telling somebody would break that role, and then the whole plan would collapse around her. So she feels forced into this back corner, which is why it was actually pretty big, if you consider her character. It was really big when she was talking, or in her inner mind or whatever, where when she would have told us the secret, she actually ended up not, and she kept it to herself. That takes some serious courage because of centuries of suffering, and right there she would have been able to confide in someone, but she still chose to remain with the image that she's been portraying for so long, just to keep protecting that long-term goal of saving everybody. I will, since I'll give some context now, because
I didn't like Farina, okay, at first. I'll just be upfront with everybody. I really do not like her personality. I thought it was really obnoxious. I didn't like the way she talked. I didn't like her attitude. I've never found that type of thing appealing or sexually attractive. And yes, I say sexually attractive because there are certain personalities where a dominant person can be sexually attractive. But I never found any of this to be anything but annoying. However, the context I have now as to why she acts that way has completely reversed my opinion on her. I still don't like the personality, but because I know why she does it, I don't have a problem with her character anymore. Because there's a reason why she's done it. And the reason why she does it was simply to play her part in the play, essentially, right? To save her people. So that's all it was for. So I accept that now. Of course, her power level is not on par with an Archon, because she's not one, so that also explains that away when I was being very critical of her originally. In fact, she has a vision. I just realized she has a vision on the front of her. I do not remember her having a vision, but now she has to have a vision, doesn't she? Because she's not the Archon, so she's just a human now. In fact, was that detail always there? I don't remember her ever having a vision. I don't even remember seeing that when we pulled her, but maybe that was. Can I look, actually? I don't know. Thought maybe I'd be able to look. Anyways, all of that stuff, all of the criticisms I had with Farina have been worked away. As far as all of the Archons are concerned, by now, I still think Nahida is my favorite, personally, but Farina is definitely the one I feel the most sympathy for by the end. Because while every single Archon seems to have suffered with some sort of, you know, agonizing bullshit in their past, every single one literally has something like that, it's both Farina and Nahida's storylines that have given me actual emotional reactions to shit. And Farina's was in regards to her, you know, more so, like, Nahida was more in regards to Ruka Devata just disappearing from existence and the fact that she felt this pain from that, those circumstances, but didn't know why, because she had disappeared. But Farina's stuff, none of that goes away. So at some point we'll do her story quest and see where Farina's story is going to go and how she's feeling and all of that kind of crap. But yeah, overall, Fontaine was definitely lived up to expectations. The actual region of Fontaine has been mind-blowing to me. I love the oceanic water exploration. I love the music, the ambience, and the calming, relaxing music that plays is probably some of the best in the game. The battle music isn't to my liking very much, but it is its own style, and so that is still something I have to respect, because every nation has its own style of audio and music, so I'm totally okay with that. But I'll have to sit and kind of analyze the whale music, the boss theme, because I didn't really get much time to listen to it there when we were doing the actual story, because there's dialogue and it goes by a lot quicker than when you're fighting it as a weekly and all that crap. So that's something I'll have to check out. There was some amazing tracks, though, throughout Fontaine. The tracks that play at night in Fontaine City, the Court of Fontaine, I love those. I really liked the tracks that play down in the fortress. That track that plays when Focalors is on screen at the end, that I don't know what to call that track, that really, like, almost solemn sort of emotional sounding track, that fucking gorgeous. And now anytime I hear that, I'm gonna remember being sad during the scenes, just like when you hear that one in Sumeru. Lots of other really cool tracks, and all of the underwater tracks, fan fucking tastic, the best, period, ambient tracks. Oh, except maybe one. There's still that ambient track in the chasm that I don't think has ever been crushed. The creepiest, most unsettling track I've heard in the game so far. So as for moving forward, I'm looking forward to Natlan, of course. I'm super stoked to see more new regions, and if it's supposed to be a nation of war, if it's going to have volcanic activity, I'm just really, really excited to see all of the possibilities there. But time will tell. I, of course, like always, have so much left to do in this game. We might have completed the Fontaine storyline and be caught up in the Archon quest right now, but that doesn't mean I have any shortage of stuff to get done. I still have countless world quests. I have countless story quests, countless hangouts. I have countless hours of exploration left to do, countless things left to do in the game, right? And hopefully, as I sit down and play more and more and more sessions, I will be able to actually do more stuff before the next major nation is released. But we'll see. It all depends, of course, on how often I play and my interest levels and whether or not I'm in shitty poopy moods. And I guess you would want me to be in shitty poopy moods, because the more often that I play, it's because I'm in shitty poopy moods. Provided I don't let them get too crappy where I don't even want to play Genshin. And those are not fun days, but I think that pretty much covers all of what I can think of right now. I'm sure there's stuff that I brushed over that I didn't actually go into detail on, but until next time, I guess. This is probably going to bring this video to an end. Some of the stuff that I'll probably get up to in the following episodes, we've got that event that I want to do. There's also weeklies and stuff, and plus I should have access to a new weekly boss, correct? Let me see, is it on the map somewhere? No. Maybe? Do I not have access to the weekly boss yet? Okay, I might have to... Oh! What is this? There it is. It's hidden for some reason... I don't know, awkwardly way out in the middle of nowhere. So it is here. And this does drop Farina's item, correct? Yes, these things. That's what I need. Okay. Oh, yeah, I didn't even mention all this weird shit of these new characters appearing and new names being dropped. It's a whole bunch of stuff to process in my brain. But that's something I'll probably have to take a look at in the next set as well. Just bunches of stuff I still have left to do. We'll see where we go. But until next time, guys, I'll see you around. Goodbye.